not sending me in alone as part of a negotiated exchange. Algonquin, young man my age, was sent to learn of the French. History has long ago lost record of his soul.
The Algonquin of the Ottawa River were a complex and sophisticated people. At the time of their first meeting with Brûlé in 1610, the various Algonquin bands had a combined population of roughly 6,000 people. Inhabiting territory too far north for agriculture, most Algonquin were organized into small, semi-nomadic bands of hunter-gatherers. They did grow corn with some success, but mostly the Algonquin relied heavily on hunting and trapping for their food. As skilled hunters, they quickly attracted the attention of the French fur traders.
The Algonquin traveled with had the confusing array of gods and spirits to which they paid homage. A great spirit or supreme creator, several lesser spirits, controlled air, water, weather, animals, birds, and availability of food. They could clearly see a life after death, where the spirits of men pursued the spirits of animals. And most intriguing, all creatures were admitted to this afterlife. The Algonquin had no concept of hell or place of eternal damnation. Their spiritual guides to
I've done little acknowledged in your